Trouble. I don't know the meaning of the word. This is the Amazing Mystery Troublemaker, 7 minutes before 11 o'clock in the morning. Wow, man, I'm not usually out in the morning. Wow, this is kind of weird, but I'm filling in for Rick Miller, who, of course, is driving in the Indy 500 today and couldn't make the show. You Better You Bet was by The Who. That doesn't sound country and western to me. I don't know. Anyways, been getting some requests, and when the people called up, you know, I've never heard the Rick Miller show, and I'm filling in for him. I want to do a show that's kind of consistent with what he does every Sunday morning. And I asked one caller who said he was a regular listener what Rick usually plays. He said Rick was heavily into polka music. So while I look through the library and try to find some, here's some reggae.
Gets me gone.
You're listening to KALX in Berkeley. I'm not sure what time it is.
What the time you have the dread? 12 o'clock natty. Roots. Aye? Is a wonder them no say dread have something to do with the pies and flour. Why? You know, all the while I'm blaming. Every hour on the hour, you hear people bawling for poison flower. I says, there's a man that live next door.
In my neighborhood. In my neighborhood.
He died through poison flower. Cause every hour on the hour, you hear the people them a bad. I said the people them a bad poison flower. Every hour.
Rejoice Sunday in the death of the bloodsucker Mohammed Reza Pahlavi, but said it would not affect the hostage crisis, the young Muslim militants holding the American hostages in Iran. Declared that their captives will not be free until the deposed Shah's stolen wealth is returned. A French radio newsman reported from Tehran since seizing the U.S. embassy and hostages last November 4th. The young radicals have demanded both the return of Pahlavi's money and the extradition of the former Shah himself to face trial.
Bomb, 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 Iran. Bomb, 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 Iran. Bomb, 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 Iran.
Some rocks, tell the Ayatollah gonna put you in a box.
Bomb Iran, bomb, 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 bomb Iran.
Bomb,
bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb Iran.
Our country's got a feeling really hit the ceiling. Bomb Iran, bomb, 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 bomb Iran.
Old Uncle Sam's getting pretty hot. Time to turn Iran into a parking lot.
Bomb Iran, bomb, bomb.
Call the financiers, better get
your ass in gear.
Bomb Iran, bomb, 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 bomb Iran.
Bomb,
bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb Iran.
Our country's got a feeling really in the ceiling. Bomb Iran, bomb, 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 bomb Iran.
Just
bomb, I ran, bomb, 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 I ran.
When I grow up to be a man, will I dig the same things that turned me on as a kid? Will I look back and say that I wish I hadn't done what I did?
I grew up to be a man. Yeah, they haven't even reached my age yet. Anyways, 6 minutes after 11 o'clock Rick Miller time on the KALX. That was When I Grew Up to Be a Man by the Beach Boys. Before that, we heard Bomberan by Vince Vance and the Valiants, and a record, a weird record, by the Observers, Observing, Observed, or something. I don't know. Anyways, we got two calls on the Bomberan record by Vince Vance, and one person called up to say that it was real offensive. And, you know, I mean, if you take it seriously, it is offensive, and we certainly don't mean it seriously. The other person wanted to know where they could buy a copy. So that's, you know, I mean, you just have to play the records and let the chips fall where they may. If I really thought it was going to be taken seriously, I wouldn't play it, but I'll play the next one. It's Kaya, and it's by the late Bob Marley.
Now. Introducing the Kitchen Orchestra. The forks. The pan lid and soup spoon. The drawers. and cupboards whipped cream and the kitchen tap. Now the egg beater and the kitchen stove and some more pans. The blender. And the toast. And now, a little kitchen cantata.
Of plastic, 'cause it'll never leave me when I'm down. Oh, me.
Berkeley.
All right, as I told you earlier, the guy who usually does this show, Rick Miller, is heavily into polka music, and I discovered that he has some polka underwriting. The following hour of programming is made possible by Wally Pedrowski's Famous Accordion Players School.
Yeah, she's too fat for me. Hello, Molly, you have flat tops. Now, how many times have you been watching the polka parade on your television and said to yourself, oh, if only I could have played the accordion like that, oh, the girls I could get. And who does get the money, the praise, the fame, and the gals at all of those big church dances? You betcha, the accordion player. So if you've been thinking that you would like to play both ends against the middle, well, why not look into the Wally Pedrowski School for the Accordion? In just 56 short easy lessons, we teach you how to play the tunes that are guaranteed to drive the gals wild. The polkas, the jigs, the older Western songs, the waltzes, the music that's always in demand. So if you want to learn to play the accordion for the pure joy of a going in and out, or simply so that you can wear the sexy lederhosen that drive the little babushkas into a frenzy, I think it's about time you enrolled in the Wally Podbroski School for the Accordion. And make sure you don't get squeezed out of all the action and you sign up today. Okay, let's go, boys. A one and a two and a one and a three.
Experiments of America, and they were doing their title track UXA. And before that, Blown to Bits was The Exploited. And has your child been immunized yet? The American Medical Association reminds you the childhood diseases have been kept under control because of a planned schedule of immunizations. Some vaccines, such as tetanus, require booster shots, but others, like those for measles and mumps, offer lifelong protection. Your physician will know the schedule of immunizations and booster doses for your child's needs. Oh, I'm tired running around getting all these records and answering the phone. Somebody called and said I was doing a pretty good job for a substitute DJ. What a... just makes my whole day, folks. Somebody else called and remembered that I used to be on the station at one time and have a regular show and be a real honest-to-goodness semi-professional DJ here. And he asked me if, now that I was back on the air, if I'd be playing music that was different from what I used to play. But no, it's going to be the same old music right now. One of my favorite tunes, Paul Anka, Having Your Baby.
Having my baby, what a lovely way of saying how much you love me. Having my baby, what a lovely way of saying what you're thinking of me. I can see it, your face is glowing. I can see it in your eyes, I'm happy in knowing that you're having my baby. You're the woman I love and I love what it's doing to you. You're having my baby.
Thank you. You got to have caution, caution.
But silly and a fool. She gone out with the boy next door, and I was left in a loose one's mind. It's a woman's world we live in, and a woman's world can't wait. It's a woman's world we live in, and a woman do things me.
Months in Brooklyn. And just like Marilyn Monroe in The Misfits, I see her on the steps of the Brooklyn divorce court. So she says to me, "How'd you meet this guy?" And I says to her in the corridor. And she says to me, "What, the corridor of your building?" And I says to her, "Yeah, he was walking up the stairs at 3 o'clock in the afternoon on a weekday. And he says to me, "Didn't I see you in the Pottery Barn at lunchtime?" And I says to him, "Yeah." And he says to me, "Did you buy that Sterling Hayden cup?" So I says to him, "How did you know I saw that cup in the long goodbye?" Then he kind of smiles and he says to me, "So what are you doing home at 3 o'clock? And I says to him, "I took the afternoon off to watch my darling Clementine on the 3:30 movie." Then he says to me, "Guess what I'm doing home at 3 o'clock? And I says, "Because they're showing my darling Clementine on the 3:30 movie." So he says to me, "What are you doing for dinner?" And I says to him, "I do this thing with vermicelli and ricotta and leftover chicken." So we watched the movie, ate dinner, got stoned, got laid, got married, and got divorced.
entitled Schizo Typesetting. Schizo typesetting has very reasonable rates